Let's deploy a basic website with HTML, CSS, and JavaScript to Vercel. So Vercel is a front-end cloud, and we support 35-plus different front-end frameworks, but sometimes you want to deploy just a basic website that uses good old-fashioned vanilla HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. And of course, we support that too. So we're going to show that today. We're going to show setting up basically the most simple website possible to get you up and running. Let's get started with our HTML starter template. So this is a very simple template that just uses a single HTML file that's going to help you get online very quickly. So on vercel.com/templates, I found this template. I'm going to click deploy. Now I already have an account. I've already connected to my GitHub repository. So I'm going to make a new private repository. Let's call this HTML starter video, and I'm going to click create. Now this is going to copy that code into a newly created Git repository, and it's going to kick off deploying our application. So in just a few seconds here, we took our HTML file, we deployed it and uploaded it to all of Vercel's Edge network regions, and now we see our site is online. So if I click out here, I can open up this new application. So we see HTML starter video.vercel.app. Every deployment gets your new .vercel.app domain. So this is already online. It's already set up with SSL. So we get this secure URL. And there's a lot of things inside of this template I want to dig into that are just kind of already set up for you. But first, if we go back to Vercel and we click on continue to dashboard, we're going to see this new project that was set up for our deployment. So if I click on deployments, for example, we see we had this one production deployment. It took 8 seconds for us to deploy this application out to production. We see the domains, we see the environment, we see the outputs. So we have under here, we have one Edge middleware, which we're going to talk about that in a second. And then we also have an index file, and then there was a README as well too. If we wanted to, we could even ignore that README from being included in our deployment. Okay, let's talk about what's included in this starter HTML file. If you want, you can always go in your browser and view the source. If you want to see the underlying HTML that's being included here, we're going to talk about some of these bits individually. So let's start at the top. First, we have analytics that's automatically set up. Now, there's only one file right now, but as you add more HTML files, you can have some nice traffic analytics as visitors are coming in, and you don't need to add any additional third-party scripts. So this is entirely first party. We've already set it up on the page. And if I wanted to just go back over to our HTML starter video project and go to analytics, I can say, you know what? I do want to enable web analytics. This all sounds great. I'm going to turn that on. And I don't even need to use any special packages here because this is just included through a good old fashioned script tag. Now this does require redeploying our site so that it can understand that we have enabled web analytics here. So I'm going to go back to our deployments. I'm going to go here on this deployment. I can just click redeploy. So we're going to redeploy this. That's going to kick off a new deployment. And now on the next deployment that we have, when I make requests to our site, granted again, it's just one URL. Now that gets aliased to HTML starter video.vercel.app. So I can just refresh the page here a couple times. That all looks good. And now if I go back over to our project and I go to analytics, it says, hey, we've now recognized there's been some traffic to your website. Let's start taking a look at what we have here. So we can filter by the different time. We can filter by the different environments. We can disable this if we want. We can add more things as needed. But we see that we're starting to pick up traffic here, and these numbers can update in real time. So we see that there's, you know, one online now. And as the page views start trickling in, we can see that number increment. So that's all it takes to get set up with some basic traffic analytics. Another thing that's great about this template is that you want the simplicity of just having a basic HTML file, but as you make changes to your site, wouldn't it be great if you could automatically update your domain, update your live deployment with those contents? So if I go over to GitHub, for example, I can see this single HTML file that was created. I can just click the edit button here, and let's say I want to call this Vercel HTML starter video. I'm going to commit my changes. We'll just go directly to the main branch for the sake of this video. And now if we go back over to our application, we click on deployments, there's a new production deployment that's kicked off, and it's taken in those new changes based on that commit. And now if I go back over to here, it's finished. I see Vercel HTML starter video. So we can iterate really quickly and push changes to our application, see them live in production. Now, the next thing on the list is fast gzip compression. So by default, there's going to be gzip compression on all of your files. So that's really great, helps speed up the response coming from our edge network. You can also use Bratley compression if you prefer. That's even a little bit better. So you can opt into that using the headers that you forward along. The last thing here to talk about is advanced routing configuration. So we included it in this template. You don't necessarily have to use it, but sometimes it can be nice. So you can use a middleware file that's going to allow you to set a bunch of headers on your files. Now, Vercel also has a static header option for this where you can include it in a Vercel JSON file, but sometimes you want to write this through code. So let's take a look at what this looks like. Okay, back over on GitHub, we see this single middleware.js file that was created in the root of our application. Basically, all it's doing is taking in the incoming web request, and it's saying, you know what, we're going to produce a web response, and we're going to include some additional security headers on here. This is a trivial example, but you can do a lot with this since you have access in JavaScript to the web request and response, and we have a bunch more documentation and examples if you want to use middleware. So the last thing I want to talk about in this template is actually how it's being styled. So if you look at the output here in the DOM, you see that there's a bunch of HTML elements, but there's no class names. We're not assigning any of these elements a class name. So where is it getting these styles from? Well, I'm actually using a single CSS style sheet. Sometimes they call these CSS Zen gardens, basically, where basically everything is styled just directly referencing the actual HTML elements. So all the P tags are going to look in a certain way. All of the H1s are going to look a certain way. This is a really easy, small thing to do that can give you, you know, a decent looking website without having to do anything extra. So I like to use these little simple hacks when I'm just building a very, very basic website. So I don't even have to write any custom styles myself. Just a fun little thing. But that about wraps up creating a very simple HTML, CSS, and you could also throw in some additional JavaScript in this file if you wanted to as well. Maybe even some jQuery. The world is yours here. And we showed how you took this and deployed it to Vercel in, I think it was 6 to 8 seconds. So really easy to get your first site online, make some changes, add some analytics, add some additional customization, really whatever you want to do while deploying on Vercel's global edge network. So this is going to be fast wherever your visitors are in the world. If you want to see more content around more basic HTML, CSS, JavaScript sites, maybe even some HTMX, I don't know, we'll see. Just leave a comment down below and we can make more videos on this. Hope you enjoyed. Peace.